So right now we are planning to send humans first to the moon and then on to Mars. So there's a big difference in the kind of radiation that we encounter on Earth versus what we encounter in space. It's very important that we prepare for this now. Protecting astronauts has always been NASA's number one priority. What we encounter on Earth is radiation that's basically a form of light, high energy light. In space, however, we have atoms, not particles of light, but atoms stripped of their electrons, moving at fractions of the speed of light.
Our sun is a very active body, and we monitor our sun for solar flares. Comparing what the general population would receive from natural background radiation, if you were a crew member in deep space, you would be receiving 50 to 60 times what we receive daily on Earth. Our universe is vast, and galactic cosmic radiation is generated outside of our solar system. Particles are accelerated in from all directions into our solar system that are moving very, very quickly up to the speed of light. At the NASA Space Radiation Research Lab, we're able to simulate the particles and the components of the galactic cosmic radiation. The particles are accelerated to high energies. We study the biological effects. For example, the radiation in space can cause complex double strand breaks to our DNA. Physically, we're going to protect our crew members with shielding. We have shelters to protect the crew members from solar particle flares, medical countermeasures, which can include dietary countermeasures, and even sleep and exercise to help mitigate these effects.
So this is the kind of research we need to do to ensure the safety and health and the well-being of our crews as we go to the moon and on to Mars.